The Matrix is everywhere. It is all around us. Even now, in this very room.
You can see it when you look out your window, or when you turn on your television. You can feel it when you go to work,
when you go to church, when you pay your taxes. It is the world that has been pulled over your eyes to blind you from the truth.
What truth?
That you are a slave, Neo. Like everyone else, you were born into bondage. Born into a prison that you cannot smell or taste or touch. A prison for your mind.
Another question about electability. Do you have any, sir? There's always the question as to whether or not you are in fact viable. Your differences with the Republicans on with the rest of the Republicans on this stage has raised questions about whether or not you can actually win the Republican nomination, sir.
So you're suggesting that I'm not electable and the Republicans don't want me because I'm a strict fiscal conservative? Because I believe in civil liberties? Why should we not be defending civil liberties?
What is he doing?
He's beginning to believe.
Let me see if I get this right. We need to borrow $10 billion from China, and then we give it to Musharraf, who's a military dictator who overthrew an elected government, and then we go to war, we lose all these lives, promoting democracy in Iraq. I mean, what's going on here?
In close consultation with Treasury Secretary Hank Paulson, Federal Reserve Chairman Ben Bernanke, and SEC Chairman Chris Cox, I announced a plan on Friday. Under our proposal, the federal government would put up to $700 billion taxpayer dollars on the line.
Madam Speaker, I rise in strong opposition to this bill. I think what's happening in the market today is signaling something much more draconian, because it's probably telling us that our government is insolvent, that we're on the verge of bankruptcy.
The Constitution doesn't provide for a central national bank. It doesn't even provide for a Federal Reserve system. Freedom, prosperity, and peace.